14 years. In other words, it normally takes 14 years for a person to master a skill. Hi everyone, welcome to a new video of Ek the Book. I'm Bakir. I love reading books. I take important lessons out of those books and share those lessons with you through videos like this to make your life better. In this video, we are going to talk about something really interesting, something that everyone wants to do, but they cannot. But before that, let me ask you a couple of questions. First, do you find yourself struggling in mastering any skill? Do you find yourself jumping between different skills? Or do you find yourself giving up while trying to learn a new skill? If the answer to all of these questions are yes, then make sure that you stay until the end of this video because I'm going to teach you exactly how you can master any new skill and why you cannot master any new skill. Okay, before going further, let's first understand what is mastery. According to Cambridge Dictionary, mastery is defined as if someone has a mastery of doing something, they are extremely skilled at it. You must be thinking, I'm good at what I'm doing, should I call myself master? Well, that depends. That depends on how long you have been practicing and how good you are at that skill. Robert Greene, in his book Mastery, says that if a skill is embedded in our nervous system and in our body, it is very hard to explain with words, but it is really easy for us to demonstrate with action. And that is a mastery. When you reach that level with any skill, you should think that you are a master. But there's also another factor that's really important for mastery. We are going to come to that later on. And this understanding is taken by tacit knowledge, according to Robert Greene. And tacit knowledge was introduced long time ago during Middle Ages, during which the masters of different crafts, they realized the demand for higher business and they could not rely on the family members. They needed to expand their business as well. So what they did, they started looking for people that could train them, they could teach them how to master the skills that they are producing to other people. But they could not rely on people who could come and go and could not stay for a longer time. So the masters at that time, they started looking for people who are from the ages of 12 until 17. They started recruiting them and signing a contract for 7 years. These young people, they had to stay with those masters for 7 years and practice and learn the skills that the masters were providing. Once after the 7 years, these young people, they are able to produce a master work or masterpiece of work, then they would be promoted to a journeyman. And at that time, they would be allowed to go and travel different parts of the world and practice and deliver the task. If we go even further than Middle Ages, our ancestors, they did not know how to communicate. The language was not developed at that time, but they still needed to learn skills like hunting, skills like tools making. How they could do that? They could do it through viewing, observing, and that is called natural learning process. Every human being, we learn better by viewing, observing, and practicing rather than communicating, rather than reading a book. Think it yourself. If you're good at driving a car, would you prefer to learn it through reading a book, or would you prefer to learn it by sitting on steering and driving the car? I bet the latter is your option. When researchers researched about how long was it for, in terms of the number of hours, for any person during Middle Ages to learn that master skill, and they come with a number of 10,000 hours. Let's count these 10,000 hours and figure out how long it would be in terms of days and months. If we divide 10,000 hours for 2 hours each day, if you practice any skill for 2 hours each day, how long is it going to take you in terms of days? We will be mastering the same skill for around 5,000 days. And if we assume that there are 30 days in each month, then there will be 167 months for mastering the same skill. And if we find it in terms of the years, which means divide the same 167 by 12 months, there will be around 14 years In other words, it normally takes 14 years for a person to master a skill. If you have been practicing a skill and it is less than around 14 years, I don't think it would be appropriate to call ourselves or yourself a master because we are not at that position yet. Now, let's learn two principles about mastering any skill, which are really important. The first principle is you should never ever try to learn two different skills at the same time. Many people, they find themselves jumping from skills to skills just because of the same reason. They try to learn different skills at the same time, but that is not possible for our brain. When our brain is distracted by another skill, it cannot create a nervous system. It cannot embed this skill in our brain and body. And principle number two is you should learn how to embrace tedium. Because when you start learning a skill, when you start practicing, you start feeling bored because you're practicing the same thing again and again, again and again for a very long time. And that may cause you feel bored for the same skill. But it is really important for us to know that these pain that we feel or these tedium that we feel from practicing the same skill again and again, we try to strengthen the nervous system in our brain, much like the physical exercise. The more we practice, the more muscle and muscular we get. And it is very common for many people to assume that life is all about pleasure. It's wrong. Life can never be every time about enjoyment and entertainment. There are certain moments that we have to deal with tedium, we have to deal with pain as well. We have already learned how to master any skill from external point of view. But what happens in our brain? How does it work? How does our neuron system react towards learning skill? Then, according to the book, Robert Greene, whenever we try to learn a new skill, our brain creates a network of neurons at the frontal cortex of part of our brain. And when these network of neurons are recruited, these system or these network help us with our learning process. And the more the skill or the practice gets harder, the more this neuron system expands in size because it needs more help to get all that information and data that it's receiving throughout the learning process. And the more we repeat the skills get hardwired and automatic in our brain system. And once it is automatic, then the brain releases and delegates that nervous system or neuron system towards learning any other skill. So that's why it's very important for us to focus on one skill at a time. At the end of the process, when we already master a skill, the brain develops a certain network of neurons that remembers the task. And that is the reason many times, for example, if you have learned riding a bicycle very long time ago and without any practicing for a certain amount of time, then you sit again on the bicycle, you can ride the bicycle as you would long time ago because that skill is already embedded in your brain and that neuron system is already there. It's inactive, it's still, but it's already present there. And when researchers researched some masters practicing their skills that they are really good at, they realized that in their brain, there was no much activity going on. It was still, it was inactive because that neuron system, that practice or that skill was already automated. It was already hardwired. And the brain didn't need a lot of effort to initiate that skill. And due to the same reason, if you are distracted with other things in your life, if you are distracted with any other skill that you're trying to learn at the same time, you will not be able to hardwire those skills in your brain system. And it will result in giving up, and because it will be very difficult for you to learn and master that skill. I hope through this video you learn how to master any skill, and I also hope that you understand what was the reason that you were not able to master any skill. Perhaps you might be trying to learn different skills at the same time, or perhaps you might be thinking that within a month or within several months of practice you should be master, but you are not at that point yet. That is just because it takes a long time, it takes a lot of patience for anyone to master any skill. So stay tuned for the next video, and make sure that you like and support this channel by writing down your comment below, and also share with us if you're planning to master any other skill in the future. I want to end this whole video with a quotation by Bruce Lee, who writes, "Practice makes perfect. After a long time of practicing, our work will become natural, skillful, swift, and steady." So this was also practiced. I mean, the same method was also practiced by Bruce Lee, who was a legend, and he has a huge name in human history. So thank you so much again for watching another video of Act the Book. See you in the next video next week. Until that time, stay safe, stay healthy. Bye-bye.